a DIY arcade fighting stick powered by a Raspberry Pi that can also be used on a PC? Stick around to find out more. It's TechWiz time. Hey guys, Jonathan here with TechWizTime, where I create technology tutorials and review videos. If you haven't subscribed, then make sure you do and hit that bell icon too. I've wanted to own my own arcade machine for as long as I can remember, and I'm guessing most of you are the same. Cost and size have always been the restricting factor though, and that's where I think this comes in, a DIY arcade joystick from GeekPi. The kit comes in two forms, one including the Raspberry Pi 3 and one without for those who want to supply their own. Links to both are down in the description below. GeekPi were kind enough to send me out the kit to review without the Raspberry Pi, as I've already got a couple lying around. Included with the kit is a zippy ball joystick, 8 large arcade buttons with inbuilt micro switches, 2 small arcade buttons for start and select, the GeekPi USB controller board, a pair of 2-inch 3-watt speakers, the laser cut acrylic pieces for the housing, rubber feet, a 16GB micro SD card, and plenty of screws, cables and wires. Constructing the kit was a little bit of a challenge. After putting components on the wrong way, I slowly learnt that the provided instructions gave clues to the correct orientation. RTFM. All up though, the whole process took around an hour, even with my mistakes. So if you do it right the first time, you're probably only going to look at about a 40-minute job. For those interested, you can see the whole process over on my personal channel, up above or down below. And here's the unit fully constructed. You've got the joystick and 6 buttons up top, and 2 smaller buttons at the front for start and select. Across to the left is an opening for the access to the network interface and 3 remaining USB ports. One of the USB ports is used to communicate with the GeekPi controller, so no messy GPIO connections to deal with. Over on the right side is 2 larger buttons used for volume up and volume down. We'll touch on this a little bit later. And finally on the rear are 2 3-watt speakers and port access for HDMI and micro USB power. The difference with the GeekPi board is the inbuilt amplifier that can power the 2 speakers. Sound is output from the Raspberry Pi through the 3.5mm cable. After construction was complete, it was time to test out the unit. Booting up from the included 16GB micro SD card showed an older version of RetroPie pre-installed. Great for those who just want to jump in, but for me it was easier to launch Etcher and write the latest version of RetroPie directly to the micro SD card. Even with the latest RetroPie, it still took another hour and a half to update. This is of course due to all the updates between now and the latest ISO release available. I should be able to play around with this eventually. Next, I install the experimental package RetroPie Manager, which allows for transferring ROMs through a web browser. So it's much easier than FTP or Samba network transfers. Follow along with my ultimate RetroPie setup guide above or down below for all the best tips and tricks for a fresh install. After transferring a few ROMs via the RetroPie ROM Manager, I have to say that it felt really awesome to navigate with the arcade stick and buttons fully configured. But alas, there was another issue. No sound through the speakers. Pressing the side volume buttons produced nothing, so once again, I jumped into the RetroPie configuration screen. Here I changed the audio from auto to force 3.5mm headphone jack, saved the configuration and did a quick reboot. Now we're cooking with gas! Except that I realised quickly that I'm not the Street Fighter champion I once used to be. I'll be needing a little more practice before attempting to beat this one again. So what are the things I loved about the DIY GeekPi arcade joystick then? Well, building it yourself is one of those things that takes a little while, but in the end feels like an accomplishment. The buttons aren't the best, but still get the job done. There's always the possibility of upgrading them yourself later down the track. The ability to access the micro SD card on the bottom is an option that some forget to include. Not here though. And lastly, you can use this as a Windows PC arcade joystick too with a USB extension cable. How awesome is that? With everything that's awesome though, there's also some things that I didn't love. The speaker quality is not that great. They produce sound, which is a plus, but the sound isn't the best by far. Let's have a listen. If you're connected to a HDMI monitor without sound, then this is better than nothing, I guess. Don't forget to check out the Amazon links in the description below for both of the DIY kits and some other things you might find interesting as well. So don't forget to check those out. What's your experience with arcade fighting sticks? Leave me a comment down below and let me know. Consider subscribing to the TechWizTime channel if you love all things technology. Are you already a subscriber? Then click on the bell icon to get instant notifications of my new videos. Like and share this video if you enjoyed it, and as always, imagine, learn, create.